So that, and that, that can be a question to the board. If we're only giving recommendations, are they holding public hearings? I really feel very strongly not to end up in the same position, because I don't know who attended the last meetings, but I did. And they were hateful. And they were hateful for the county to sit through, and they were hateful for the parents to sit through.
And you said last meetings.
The last meetings over school closures were very intense. They were very hateful meetings. And it left board members and honestly, in my opinion, central office staff and everybody in uproar. And the biggest complaint I felt I heard attending those meetings was the public really felt like they never had an opportunity to give input in any part of the process. And it was too late by the time they were given an opportunity to give input. So I just want to make sure that as a member of the community, we are being conscious of what happened last time to not repeat the same mistake. Mm-hmm. That's where I'm coming from.
Mm-hmm. We do put it out to the public prior to presenting to the board. What can we do with that information?
We may do nothing. We might do something. It depends on what the information is. I mean,
I think you could say that, you know, you go here, and it isn't possible that it will modify some of our recommendations. You know, ideas can come up. It's also possible we'll hear things and say, you know, yes, that was already discussed and we decided not to do that, or it's a new topic we do have to discuss. You know, I think all of those can happen.
Well, I mean, here's the thing. For efficiency, maybe that wouldn't be the right characterization, but so it would be two-edged, right? So the public is going to input, right? So we're doing that. So we're going to provide input, and we're going to do our analysis, we're going to look at it, we're going to, and it's going to inform our recommendations, right? And so that's done. So that's listening to the public, and we're going to present those recommendations to the board. The second part of the public input wouldn't be input so much as comment, that I think it would be reasonable to work out a way to solicit comments against our recommendations, not necessarily that we're going to change it and go back to the board, because that's what we did in the first place, right? That's what we did, what we'll do when we're going to have the public hearings. And so it'll be twofold. It'll be getting the input, make our recommendations, then allowing the public to comment against those, and we can collect them and provide an executive summary or synopsis of the public comments against our recommendations to inform the board to make a decision. And so it would be twofold from the public input.
I would just add to that that after we've heard from the public and they've had their comments, we should at least convene to say, did we hear anything that might alter our recommendations? Was some new information brought up, some idea that we hadn't thought about? And I think that would also be an acknowledgement that we really were listening to the public.
Oh, sure.
Even if we said, no, there's nothing there that we're going to change, you know.
Sure.
But it would be, you know, because I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
And I almost feel like we need to bend over backwards in a sense.
I agree.
Correct for what I understand was that process. I wasn't part of it. I understand there was a...
It was not pretty.
Closures never are, and it may be that we're not even can closure closures. So
we
may not be an issue.
That.
It may be that our recommendations are, you know, rather mild and not non-controversial. We don't know at this point until we've gone through the process. So, other people, other thoughts about process?
The only other question I have, if you don't mind, is in taking public input for people to submit written input, do we have a designated email or someone they can turn it into that then gets to us?
I mean, we would normally set that up at any hearing we can.
Okay.
Those are public comments.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely want to have them. Another question is, do we want to develop a survey of some kind? I know there's been a lot of surveys and people may feel that they've been surveyed to death already.
Yeah, they have.
So, let me
myself.
Okay.
I believe we've included the survey back up in here.
Yeah.
The Singer.
Well, the survey was for, yes, Dr. Singer's work, very thorough, and I think that we could use that as a basis for, you know, moving forward without having to survey again. Unless we come across any questions that weren't discussed that we think that we do need to have public input on. But why don't we just hold back until we come to it?
Okay.